So how many is this? Three laps.
Yeah.
Two chill laps and one espresso. Where's our leader?
Jason.
He's not at the back of the pack.
He's not leading.
He's leading.
Leading from the rear, like a general.
Up front here, though, we got like a whole bunch of 1.8s and 0.9s and...
I know, I'm cruising here at the front. 1.8, yep.
There's the orca.
So it looks like some people have completed the Tron bike and the California one. Now they're on the tour of Italy.
Oh, really? What else they have. Tour of Italy challenge?
Yeah.
Oh, you have to get past the Tron first to open up Italy?
No,
I think just the Everest and then California. Well, actually, maybe. I don't know. I haven't gotten there yet.
I think it's not grayed out. I think you can open it. And I'm not there yet.
Then Italy's been out for a while.
They've got the mystery box also, right?
Somebody's got their mic. Apparently in the back of their chammy.
Max Brennis.
Max, you got sweaty, Mike. I'm gonna mute you for a bit until it gets fixed.
Perfect. Thank you, Max.
Yeah.
Who do we think is the friendliest in ODZ?
Haskell.
Nah. I don't know. I don't like many of you.
No, but that's not how you express it. You express it with friendliness.
Oh, okay.
I can't wait for you to get a power reader. That was the most kind thing I've ever heard you say.
It's gotta be rich, right? For a few strange women in the gym.
Absolutely. He's a giver.
I think in that instance he was thinking about taking.
Well, sure. Therese has given out the most juice boxes.
I think the nicest person might be the person who's bed sniped the most.
Oh dear. You would drop that when I don't have it queued up.
Oh. Pascal.
Next time.
Oh.
There's been a little going on.
Is that getting daughter married?
Yeah. And we thought after Saturday life would get easy, but we've had just this parade of family from and friends from all over in town. And they all want to come and spend a few hours with us.
On Zwift, right?
I wish.
You're like checking the family tree. Who was that again?
Yeah, who is this person?
There's like five people in front of him right now.
Small group ahead of Jason.
Yeah, the last group left at 11:40 last night.
Uh-oh. Oh, we lost a bunch there.
They had their flat road on still.
I just moved up in the standings, people.
Yeah, I like my finishing prospects now. I
like my chances today.
There were a lot of...
Somebody's going to get really tired trying to catch back on. Can't imagine they were just needing a lead out for the turn. Hank's already.
Quick lap.
Probably arrive at the same time.
Probably.
I tried it.
What is it? It's a 16-minute lap?
Roughly.
At this pace, yeah.
Seems like it's been a long time since I've done this lap.
Yeah, it does. This way. It's been kind of crazy.
I don't think I've ever done reverse hills. It's always been reverse flat.
User entered your channel. Well, what about before there was a reverse flat?
Never was.
So I'm trying to integrate either figure eight or the quote-unquote mountain lap into the coffee ride, but we'd have to pick markers at where to start. Right. Laps. So, should we avoid that headache or not?
You can start the espresso lap in Sprint Town after the reverse KOM.
On figure eight?
Yep.
Yeah, we could do that.
Would that put you in about halfway?
A little further than halfway.
That's fine. It's just coffee.
On the mountain ride, you could start the espresso at the apex. But downhill race.
Oh, yeah.
Good luck keeping it together to the top.
Yeah, that could be tricky.
Fatties unite.
This I little hill, we're already spread out.
On the mountain, you almost have to go fairly flat for the relaxed part, and then go espresso up the hill.
I'm really excited to actually get back on a schedule where I can get the fitness that I had before Ecuador back.
Hey, Busty, can you message out to the guys that you're with to bring it back? You guys are pretty far ahead.
Yeah. If I can remember how to do that.
M,
yeah, on your keyboard.
Max is back.
So one of the things that I do is I programmed one of my hotkeys to mute my mic. So if I get any grief, I can just reach forward, tap one button, and my mic
I think you just goes hit away. The button.
I like the way it said O-H-D-Z. That was awesome. At least it's closer than it used to be, though.
Risky may have a problem with that one.
I got stuck last night in a world of watching Scottish voice recognition.
What?
And it's a fun world to get stuck in.
Scottish voice recognition?
Apparently, the iPhone can't understand a damn word they say.
Kind of like the rest of the world.
And we're not even talking like after being in a pub for 10 minutes. We're talking people that actually seem to speak reasonably normal. Just the way they inflect on their words. Can't figure it out.
I feel like crap.
Exactly. There's one where these two guys are in an elevator that's voice activated with no buttons of any kind. They can't get out. They can't get to where they want to go. I was just thankful not to have to watch those damn ostrich following those bikers again.
Oh, that was pretty good.
That was pretty good, but I've seen it like 80 times now, and it even finally made the news on TV, so it's like, you know, once it's done that, it's been out too long.
I stopped watching the news. Well, I never started, but if I had watched it, I would stop when they started quoting Twitter. 3 seconds right. ago on Twitter, so-and-so says, okay. This just in. Random person shared on Facebook. Probably not that bad, but...
Monday will be.
Mostly just for traffic and weather, right? Speaking of weather, I hear my friends in Southern California have some.
For about 60 minutes.
The thinning out of the pack.
All those guys on the road come back yet?
I don't know, but if you accidentally hit flat, you're going to have to push the button every single time or go off again.
We're going to light up this leaderboard when we do the espresso lap.
Thinking.
Yeah.
Boom. Lit up.
It's all lit up. Oh.
Well, I got 15th with me and we were not even trying, so. There you go.
My 30-day best. 3 minutes faster than the fastest time.
Mine's 13:56. Best okay. is 15 right now, so basically we're all in the top 10.
Two and top a half, 20. I lied.
Hendrick, oh, go ahead.
You're in the group, but your avatar moves, for whatever reason, out to like the left or right, and you're not technically in the draft. Are you in the algorithmic draft?
Yeah, I think so. Probably. Unless you see the little thing come up telling you to get back in.
I don't know. I think you might not be sometimes.
Generally, I think it used to be you weren't.
Just lean back into the pack.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lean over.
Drop your hand. Right? Signal that you're coming in.
ODZ English.
You also don't look at your avatar if it's more upright than you're drafting. It sucks.
Yeah. That's the real clue. You guys sitting up, you know you're drafting. If he's hunkered down, you're pushing wind.
Wind on Twitter.
Well, it's kind of interesting when you move up through the group. Typically, you're in the middle, busting people apart. Unlike in real life, if you're going to move up through the group, usually you're going to do it on the outside, not piss everybody off.
Not clip everybody's rear derailleur?
Exactly. Shoulder to shoulder. Pinball machine.
Stuff starts missing out of your rear jersey pocket because you've been pickpocketed.
Right.
Hey, where'd my right arms go?
Next race you do in real life, go right up through the middle. Upward.
That's what I'm planning to do in my race on Saturday.
Hopefully it's not a time trial.
Eric, how was the race?
Yeah, how was the race, Eric?
Apparently Eric's dead.
Oh, I'm here. Sorry.
How was your race?
I've totally screwed up the logger here. I'm attempting to get my guy in position before we get around.
Got it.
Race was good, though. I won.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Like number one, you won?
Like number one.
Damn.
Got to kiss the trophy girl.
What did the
yep.
What did somebody say on the way to the finish line, Eric?
They were like, there was a couple guys that were sitting at the finish line watching. They yelled to the guys that came in second and third.
You just got schooled by Team Zwift.
I didn't even know who the guy was. It's like somebody following my Strava or something.
I'm telling you, we need iron-on patches for our jerseys so people know what's up.
Awesome.
Or not.
Or maybe we don't, right? Maybe we stop talking about it.
We don't get enough benefits from it yet.
Yeah, they won't even give us a ride leader spot.
I bet they know it's real now, right?
Way to go, Eric.
Thanks.
Still afraid to go outside. Like it's always
interesting. It had a steep learning curve there for the first bit.
Like being on two wheels.
Remembering how to turn and draft.
Holy crap, you have to steer this thing.
Yeah.
Whoa!
There was a steep downhill with
Dude,
a corner.
Dude, they fixed leaning. It actually works now.
Yeah. It worked all right. A steep downhill with a corner right after the start finish, and it was a favorite spot for people to attack. It was like 50 mile per hour downhill. You had to be on your game.
You got an achievement?
Yeah, I got the achievement.
And since you basically are not afraid to go balls out in a corner now.
Yeah. Well, I got gapped there the second time we came through and had to learn quick.
What'd you say, it was like 30 miles or something?
Yeah, it was pretty short.
Awesome.
So it took you, what, 45 minutes?
Yeah. Yeah, it was about 25.
Hard part's waiting behind the leader the first two laps. You're like, who are we following again?
Yeah, they didn't have the leader beam working there either.
Because it was on you.
Yeah.
That's it.
No D power up front.
No.
Were you looking for your power ups to drop?
Yeah. Looking for the arrow helmet right at the finish there for sure.
Damn, where's the arrow helmet?
He was waiting for his avatar to signal when he needed a water break.
Oh, I was supposed to drink.
Tell him about how that whole course works in the finish.
Well, it's just a 5-mile loop, like a circuit race pretty much. But there was about a 15-mile-per-hour wind coming across one side. So the whole finish stretch, which is about 2/3 of a mile, had a strong tailwind.
Baby.
Nice.
So that was another favorite spot for everyone to attack. No draft benefit, basically.
How fast did you cross the finish line at?
Well, there's a climb right before the finish, too.
Oh, okay.
So you turn, and you're just bombing along with this tailwind at like 35 plus, and then there's just a 200 to 300 foot roller of a climb that kind of falls flats and really starts to level out, and then you've got 200 more meters to the finish. So,
got it.
I was behind those guys coming into that hill. Two guys took off, and I caught them right as we crested kind of the false flat area. One of them tried to sprint. I just unloaded. I crossed with like 30 yards ahead. Yeah.
Yeah. Did you mouth the words?
Nobody was even close.
They're like, what's he saying? Oh my God, he's gonna kill us.
He had Bluetooth speakers in his back pocket for the announcement.
He just went by him and said,
yeah.
Right on.
Right on, baby.
Right on. Yeah, actually Haskell was controlling the soundboard, my Bluetooth speakers out of my pockets.
Now, were you able to wait though, or was that not allowed?
Not allowed.
Not, dang it.
I guess you could have.
Well, he could have
added some on. Picked that out, didn't you?
Only the Justin's wagon way.
Got a backpack and he's still beating us. True story, Eric rode the buffalo bike.
Yeah.
Middle speed?
The old one. The old one. Not the new one. Still the lightest
bike there is. Did put disc wheels on it though.
Imagine some guy in Africa is trying to find those disc wheels for it. Oh, these first two are going too fast.
Yeah, it's almost done.
I know.
Go time.
Fun pace is just about over.
This is fun pace?
Chris, you've been out of it for a while.
Fun.
Eric, is that you in the white shorts today?
Yeah.
God, I hate seeing that in real life.
Hey, at least it's not raining.
It's not as bad in a race, but when you see commuters doing it, it's like, dude.
Yeah.
A, black will make you look thinner. B, dude.
Well, I don't think it's as bad as long as they stay on the bike. It's the podium where it looks bad.
Especially when you got a big sweat spot and everything.
Standing up, holding their arms up.
Especially when it's muddy and they get a little rooster tail going on.
Yeah.
At least I hope it's from the outside.
It's a little hair for a tramp stamp.
I was just at Castelli designing our team's kit. And we're doing a spray on the back. And I noticed on the skin suit, cut
curved down on the back, on the butt. I'm like, that's a little funny. So I email, I'm like, hey, you know, I've sat in the back a lot of packs and the people that have the lighter colored skin suits and stuff, you know, seeing their butt crack really doesn't do it for me. Can
have me fixed. And oh, you want the non-we like butt crack version? Okay.
Yeah.
That's like, an option on the order form. You didn't see that?
Did they tell you just ride faster and you won't have to look at it?
Well, yeah. Like, I see your point. Let me turn the like, cut.
Well, I see your crack. That's funny.
But yeah, being able to put a put in an email. Yeah, you know, I've seen a lot of butt cracks over the years.
Guys, watch your position. We're getting way strung out here.
Okay, regroup on Flores.
Yeah, get behind Flores.
We just took off and I have to work.
Hey, Danny. Eric, can you message out to you guys? Sit down.
Yeah, looks like Alex, Bussy, Rich, Bach, all the guys are up here with me, Quan.
We just don't want to let the new king of outdoor riding beat us.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a family thing between you and Charisse tearing people up, man. Dang.
I saw Charisse and Tiffany together in real life.
No way.
On Saturday, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Which one was going after
the others? Were they doing the attack, counterattack?
Yep.
Eric, who was the first to the top of the bell tower?
Oh, let's see. I don't know. First out of the elevator?
Yeah.
Not sure who it was. We're going to have to go back to the photo finish on that one.
Okay.
Get anything good?
Right. Yeah, what'd you get, Haskell? We all have to get something. Your game sounds are getting piped in.
Oh, we gotta fix that. Oh, I just got a ride on.
God, I am so fat, I'm just coasting away from everybody.
Weight doper problems.
Yeah. Gotta see how far back Jason is.
Back away still.
Oh, we gotta slow up here.
Yeah, we gotta really slow up.
Rich, Bussy, you guys are way up there.
Oh, really?
12 seconds.
Yes.
Okay.
Back her off.
I'll back her off.
Turning her down.
Just stay standstill right at the finish line.
That should work well, yeah.
Always has in the past.
Yep.
Back, we'll say hi when they fly by.
We're just coming under the bridge now.
Oh, God, we got to really slow down. User joined your
channel. Now, Flores is 2 seconds back. User disconnected from your channel. He's right there.
Here we come.
Yes, but he's been known to slow down before the start.
Okay, he's just been tail gunning, you know that.
Yeah. There he is.
All right, okay.
I'm gonna activate my second line, get more bandwidth.
Oh, good God.
That should help.
You've got mail.
Oh, look at that. Look at that lead out for Jason. Oh my gosh, perfect.
Yeah.
Giddy up!
Casey's on fire.
Brutal sprint to start the lap.
Cyclocross.
Yeah, no kidding.
Start with the sprint.
Jason taking leader duties very seriously. Gonna lead all the way to the finish line.
Oh, that was a fast start.
So, Flores, Denning, Gagnon, Jim, all made the cut, and Wags, of course. Knee-high and Butty trying to get back on at 8 seconds back.
I'm actually trying to get back to the group.
There's no group to come back to.
It's all busted.
Totally.
That was a fast start. A lot of A's have missed the front group.
Did I do that?
No. Okay, it was you.
Yeah, I wish you him all right.
Whoops, did I do that?
Another attack going on. They're trying to separate the A group.
User in your channel timed out. Oh god, this sucks.
The side view actually looks kind of cool.
I thought I'd get it.
That's how I'm going for that.
How many more split sprints will it take?
All of them.
Joined your channel. Fucking bets now.
Flores claims the kid fat flat. We need to.
We gotta hear proof.
Data integrity.
Yeah. Need some audio on that.
Can't wait to get my Tron bike.
Shiny.
Alex, I thought you were feeling crappy. Yeah, he's all in front there.
Some of your best rides are when you feel crappy.
Apparently.
Holy crap, Justin.
approaching the garage. Alex, do it. Alex, you have put in a good 4-minute effort here and you got it. He's not on TeamSpeak, huh?
I don't think so.
3:44? No way.
You can start insulting him then. Those bloody Canadians.
Alex's heart rate is 166, I'll just let you guys know. When he starts to blow up, then you can attack.
Well, Eric's at 175. Wagner at 185.
Eric is half rabbit, though, so.
Jim at 175, so they all look like they're working just as hard.
Wagner.
Jim on the attack. Well,
300 heart rate. Heart rate matches his wattage.
I'm beating my age, my age.
Well, there we go. There we go. Gagging on up to 172. He's gonna hit his max, babies. Time to attack.
Jim leading the push at 7 to 6 watts per kilogram. They will come back together. They're even being caught from behind by French.
Justin's only at 190. He's still got 200 beats per minute left. Oh, Justin, come on, don't hold back, dude. I see your wattage. You can do better than that.
Who's gonna blink first?
I think Justin's saving it for the sprint. And it's gonna be between Justin and Eric in the sprint, that's why.
Well, they're letting French get back. He's 5 seconds behind them. Perry only 7.
Ooh, French is putting out some crazy power. 450 watts.
4 seconds back. And he's got the green jersey and the man's jersey. So
guys, you gotta use your power-ups now if you have them.
Jim starts to put the pace down again, 7 watts.
French is gonna... He's starting to sprint to catch up to you guys. Keep pushing. Make him chase.
Jim and Justin Jim and have Justin got a little gap.
460 watts? His heart rate's only 164? It's insane.
Dead power there.
See a big dude.
Okay,
huge dude.
Four leaders back together.
Remember, guys, we still count Z power here. He's right on your tails. About to get to the KOM crest.
Four still together, Wacken, Denning, Schoening, Gagnon, French closing fast behind, gonna catch them.
Here, Alex has to keep pedaling because he's the lightest of them all, I'm assuming.
Uh-oh, Frenchie!
And French goes blowing past them. Now, group of 5 on the descent.
What was that? You, Andy, you sound different today.
I'm not breathing hard. I'm sitting in an office enjoying myself.
Seriously, another feather?
Justin, putting the power down.
Wow, Alex.
Then what's the kilogram?
4 seconds ahead. But I have a feeling. Oh, and Justin's not holding back.
He's
not holding back.
Aero helmet and 10 watts per kilogram. Killing it.
Aero is the best power up, right? For the finish, pretty much?
Yeah.
Other than the drafting boost, even?
Justin's still holding 6 to 7 watts per kilogram. Got 12 seconds already on Alex and Shim. Denny in 4th place, French 5th. Yeah, looks like Justin's got this one. Alex is 2 seconds ahead of Shim. This one could come down to the wire. Denning a further 2 seconds back, putting down some power. Justin crosses the line. Alex second.
Today's fastest lap time.
Denning, I think, stole third from Shim.
Yeah, nice sprinter.
Very good job, guys. Very good job.
Oh man. Oh God.
That was the lap of pain. Holy cow.
Sub 13, baby. Oh. Suck it. That hurt.
I had good power up until the last one. I couldn't get a good one.
I saved one for the end on the hill, and that's the only one I used.
I held on to my air helmet for like the whole time.
As you know, I use my air helmet.
All right, look at the sprint.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
On rock.
Yeah. Rock.
Backwards, Barber. Barber just sneaking ahead of the line.
Oh man, that was a bike race.
Lots of good sprints coming, lots of good sprints.
Here we go.
Here comes old man Haskell.
Grandpa Haskell soon.
Great ride, guys.
I broke Buxuski on the hill. That was fun.
Hi, boy, Haskell.
They say Haskell is as old as Buddha.
Go, Haskell, put a gap on him. Let's go. Go.
Don't give up.
He's catching you. Come on.
Minute gap.
Let's go.
Haskell, you got TODC behind you.
Hammer time!
Headley, that's 70 RPM.
Go, Haskell!
Haskell, even your avatar has a big butt. Why is that?
Baby. Wow.
Oh, my God.
User disconnected from your channel. Nice job, Ash.
Oh, thanks.
I tried really hard to catch you.
Hey, Rich Rutherford, you killed me.
All right, Gail. Sprint.
Yeah, come on, Gail. Why
going. Bad boy, Gail.
He's on you. You got to keep it up.
Oh, he's right on your tail. He's on your tail. Go.
Oh, he saw you sprint. He's coming.
He's coming. Oh, he's putting down some massive wattage.
There you go, man.
Wow, that was close. Too close to call. Good job.
I think Gail got it.
You're going to have to review the footage.
Yeah.
It looks like FTL threw some spikes down in front of your tires there, Gale. Old school racing for you.
They're doing the zero.
So. Good job, guys.
We were coming up the backside KOM, and I get a little get gapped by Buxuski and Indonesia, and so I'd like throw a little, you know, dig to try to get back on, and the momentum, of course, carries you over the top, and there's a little delay in the power, and every time I did, Buck would spike. He just, you know, like, oh no, he's trying to attack, and I thought, well, maybe I should do some attacks. So, like every minute, almost on the minute, I'd put in like a 20-second dig, and he would chase hard. When we got to the top, I attacked over and through the banner and used my arrow as soon as I pointing downhill. And
nice.
I'm watching his power, and it's like 4-8, 5-2, 2-1. 1-8.
Cracked.
You smashed him.
Oh, he said, great ride, Chris. You almost nailed it.
You interrolled him to death.
You got to use those apex rollovers, man.
Yeah, those arrow helmets are powerful.
Yeah, Eric and Justin did some big digs to hold me back when I dropped those helmets.
Yeah, man, that was hard.
How far was Daniel ahead of us at the top? 20 seconds?
20 seconds?
I don't know. Yeah, because we were all together funny. Coming through the banner, and I attacked, and he went over top of me.
He just used his arrow helmet too early.
So who took it? I missed that.
I did.
I believe it was Justin.